Today, we will discuss the topic double fertilization and triple fusion in angiosperms. What is fertilization? Before going to discuss the fertilization, let us understand male reproductive part of the flower and female reproductive part of the flower. Male reproductive part of the flower is the stamen, and each stamen consists of three parts: filament, connective, and anther. Inside the anther, there are large number of dusty particles and the pollen grains. Female reproductive part of the flower is the gynoecium, and individual unit of gynoecium is the carpel, and each carpel consists of three parts: ovary, style, and stigma. Here, inside the ovary, there are oval bodies, and these oval bodies are the ovules, and this ovule having embryo sac or the female gametophyte. When the anther matures, the anther dehisces and the pollen grains discharge from the anther and transfers to the stigma of the flower, and this process of transference of pollen grains from the anthers to the stigma is called pollination. Now here, what happens here? This stigma exudates some sticky substance, and due to sticky substance, these pollen grains adheres to the stigma of the flower. Now, what is the process of fertilization? What is fertilization? The fusion of male gamete with the female gamete is called fertilization. And the phenomenon of fertilization was first reported by Strasburger in 1894. The process of fertilization occurs in four main stages, and these four main stages are germination of pollen tube on stigma, growth of pollen tube entry into embryo sac, and the fusion of gametes. Here you can see here the diagram of gynoecium. This is the style, this is ovary, and this is stigma. Now here, this pollen grains landed on the stigma of the flower. Here, this pollen grain germinates. When the pollen grain is shed from the anther, it has two cells, the smaller generative cell and the larger vegetative cell. The generative cell eventually forms the two male gametes. Now, what is the process of germination here? You can see here, this is pollen grain and this is the pollen tube. Here, the pollen grain consists of two layers. The outer is exyne and the inner is intyne. At the time of germination, the exyne ruptures and the intyne comes out in the form of a pollen tube. See here, this is the pollen tube. This intyne comes out in the form of a pollen tube. Generally, only one pollen tube produces the pollen grain, and it is called mono. The pollen grain is called monosyphonous. And in some cases, this pollen grain produces more than one pollen tube, and the pollen grain is called as polysyphonous. Now here, this pollen tube is formed. What happens here? This pollen tube passes through the style, and then enters into the ovary, and then this pollen tube penetrates into the ovule. Here, this pollen tube penetrates into the ovule by three ways, and these three ways are: one is porogamy, chalazogamy, and mesogamy. Can see here the diagrams. porogamy, chalazogamy, and a mesogamy. This is the pollen tube. And this pollen tube, when this pollen tube penetrates into the ovule through microbial, is known as porogamy. And this is the commonest way of entry of pollen tube. The another way is the pollen tube. This is again pollen tube, and this pollen tube penetrates into the ovule through chalaza, and it is called chalazogamy. And the third way, that is here again this pollen tube, and this pollen tube penetrates into the ovule through integuments, is called mesogamy. Now, what is double fertilization? It's double fertilization. Now here, this is diagram. This pollen tube containing two male gametes. Now here, this pollen tube penetrates into the ovule, then enters into the embryo sac. This is embryo sac. This embryo sac, or the female gametophyte, is 8 nucleate. This female gametophyte, the 3 nuclei at the microbilar end is called egg apparatus, consisting of 2 synergids and 1 egg cell. Then the 3 nuclei at the chalazal end are the antibodal cells, and the 2 central cell containing 2 polar nuclei. So that this embryo sac is 8 nucleate. Now here, this pollen tube enters into the ovule. Now here, the tip of the pollen tube, when this pollen tube enters into the embryo sac, the tip of the pollen tube disorganizes, and the content means the two male gamete discharge into the embryo sac. Now what happens here, one of the male gamete fuses with the egg cell to form the zygote, and this process is known as syngamy, and the other male gamete fuses with this two polar nuclei, and it forms triploid nucleus, or the primary endosperm nucleus. And this process is called as the triple fusion. Here, both the male gametes released by pollen tube are involved in fertilization, and this involvement of both the gametes during fertilization is called as double fertilization. Here, both the male gametes, the process of syngamy and triple fusion occurs simultaneously in angiosperms. And after fertilization, the zygote develops into embryo, and primary endosperm nucleus develops into the endosperm. Now, let us understand what is the significance of double fertilization. Double fertilization stimulates the plant to convert the ovary into fruit and ovules into the seed, along with the degeneration of other floral parts. Yes, the ovary develops into the fruit and ovules into the seed. Then another significance of double fertilization is double fertilization results in the formation of triploid primary endosperm nucleus, which develops into endosperm. And this endosperm provides nutrition to the developing embryo. These are the significance of double fertilization. What is the process of double fertilization? The term double fertilization was first reported by H.G. Nawashin in 1898. Here, during the double fertilization, the pollen tube always enters into the embryo sac at the micropylar end. Inside the embryo sac, one male gamete fuses with the egg nucleus to form diploid zygote. This process is known as syngamy. The other male gamete fuses with polar nuclei of central cell to form triploid primary endosperm nucleus, and this process is known as triple fusion. And both the male gametes released by pollen tube are involved in fertilization, and this involvement of both the gametes during fertilization is called as double fertilization. This is about the double fertilization and triple fusion. And the topic is over. Thank you.